here is the tail to one of the long-tailed, ripple-flaked, oblique arrowheads, like those found in the 2010 excavations. They would have consisted of a triangular, oblique arrowhead with a tail coming from one corner, which would have practically been used to haft them, but it's likely that these examples were never used. And was simply as a ritual deposit. You can see on the tail the fine parallel flakes taken off by pressure flaking to give the ripple effect that gives the arrowhead its name.
I was on my day off and I volunteered to do some digging because I have a lot of digging experience, having been a professional field archaeologist in the past. I was given the choice deposit to excavate. It was the layer sealing the occupation layer, which was on top of the chalk floor in the Neolithic building. So I was really chuffed to be digging this deposit.
Find emergency!
We found a tail.
They found
Don't tell him!
I'm not
going
to run.
Found a bit of flint.
Found a burial.
Polished axe.
A beaker burial.
Oh, lovely. It's, oh, that is beautiful, actually. That's wonderful. You've got another... It's the tail of one of these long tails. They seem to be unique to Marden. But it's a tail. Yeah, this might even refit on one of the ones in the museum. Last time I saw these arrowheads, they were being excavated. Okay, so we can immediately see that the colour of the flint works quite well with that one there. Well, both of them, in fact. Let's put them on that white background.
Not quite in there.
Oh, that's a yes!
No way!
It is!
No,
it is!
That's so exciting.
Fabulous!
It fits!
About 5,500 years later.
And then 5 years between excavating the two, and we've finally got the rest of the arrowhead.
And look at that for a piece of flintwork.
Isn't that amazing?
It's just astounding.
I can imagine the annoyance, the shouts of anger when that incredibly fragile tail just snapped off. The number of hours that went in to create that arrowhead.
Yeah.
Skills are doing in the first place. It's just unbelievable.
Back in 2010, when we were excavating at Marden Henge, we uncovered two remarkable arrowheads. These arrowheads are absolutely exquisite. Technically, they are ripple-flaked, oblique arrowheads, but what marks them out from other arrowheads from elsewhere, from that particular time, is one extraordinarily long tail on one side. These are not arrowheads that could have been used in everyday circumstances. You wouldn't have taken one of these hunting. No, these are something else. These arrowheads are show-off items. They are somebody showing off their ability, their craftsmanship. In terms of quality, these arrowheads are truly unique for this period and this country. If you want to look for anything similar in terms of the craftsmanship involved, you have to turn your attention to the continent, where they are producing some beautiful barbed and tanged arrowheads.
So whilst excavating this deposit, I found what looked like a sliver of bone, but on closer investigation, I realised it was the tail of an arrowhead. A very, very finely worked, exciting find. At which point, I grabbed my camera and put the arrowhead in the hands of a student and Jim coming over to look at it. And it was in fact, it was the most exciting find of my entire archaeological career.